Well, it is a new year, and we all are looking to have a new us. Well, here to help us out is Dr. Lombardo with a little help with a new year, a new you, stress-free for 2022. Last time we talked about getting out of the red zone, and that is definitely a way to have a stress-free 2022. But doctor, let's talk it. Everybody wants to be in harmony.
Our zen-like place. That's right. That's right. So what can we do? Well, the first thing people always ask me is, should I have a New Year's resolution or should I not? What I recommend is that you focus on what you want to create without that added pressure of perfectionism. And even people who say, I'm not a perfectionist, consider this. A lot of time what happened, January 1st comes and they make these grand gestures. I'm going to give up all sugar, all booze. I'm going to go to the gym every day. And then January 2nd happens, right? And they have a cookie. I had one cookie to ruin my diet. I might as well have the rest of the plate. That all or nothing mentality really interferes with us creating our best life. So what I recommend is you think about what would I like to experience and create this year and take the steps, no matter how big, to work towards that. And remember, I was saying it's not failure, it's data. If you mess up, if you don't go to the gym, or if you do have a cookie, it's not failure, it's just data. It's information to remind you, how can I get back on track?
You know what? I love that because I was told that. It's like, do not make goals because you will fail at them, or not so much fail, but you'll have a learning experience that you might not want to have. And so it's almost like, what would you like to see for yourself during 2022 is what, you know, I've been told to do. And that's the way you're saying it. Like, don't say, okay, you know what? I'm going to lose 25 pounds by February because I want to be ready for spring break or the beach or anything like that. It's just more, and that helps take away the stress.
It does, because that's the thing. We have these goals and we think that they're going to bring us more joy, more peace, more fulfillment. And yet when we don't achieve them, we start beating ourselves up, and that can cause more problems. Because what happens when we feel stressed? A lot of people, for example, have emergency sessions with those two famous therapists, Ben and Jerry. Right. And so we're stressed out about not losing weight, and then it can cause us to eat more. So focus on what you want to create. Give yourself the grace. Realize you are human. And so it's not necessarily going to be a straight line, but get back, focus on what you want, and take the steps to work towards that. Yeah.
And I like what you said about it's not failure, it's just data that you take. And I think we put failure so much on when we don't accomplish something, but getting there, we have accomplished things, right, doctor?
Absolutely. And learning from that. So if your goal is to exercise and you say, I'm going to exercise after work, and you go a whole week without exercising, well, look back. Why didn't I? Oh, well, after work, I'm exhausted, or meetings come up, or I need to take care of the kids. That's information. So then you can say, well, when can I work out? Maybe wake up a little bit early. Maybe go for a walk during lunch. And so using that information to help you work towards that desired goal.
All right. What are some quick tips that we could do to help us be stress-free at work, at least, and around our family?
Yeah. So I have something called a 3x5. Three times a day for just 5 minutes, do something healthy and helpful to reduce your stress and increase your happiness. Maybe that means 5 minutes of meditation or deep breathing, writing in a gratitude journal, going for a walk at lunch, spending time with people who you care about, watching a funny video. When you start to incorporate these in your life, instead of that stress level creeping up throughout the day, what you're doing is helping to keep it down lower. And when your stress is lower, not only are you happy, the people around you are happier, you are healthier, and you can be better productive at work.
Yes. And we want to remind, it's not just the women being stressed, it's also men being stressed. And both of these work for you know, again, for everybody.
Absolutely. Everybody gets stressed, right? Everybody gets into that red zone, that high level of stress. What we want to do is help you get out and stay out. Because when you're in that red zone, when you're at that 7 out of 10 or higher on the stress scale, we don't think rationally and we don't interact rationally. We can't be the person who we truly want to be. To taking these steps and realizing, I'm not saying 90 minutes of yoga every day. 5 minutes for just three times a day will absolutely help you reduce that stress and keep it at a lower rate.
2022 will be the stressless 2022. Doctor, tell them where they can find your book, Get Out of the Red Zone.
You can find Get Out of the Red Zone at Amazon, and it is available and ready for you to really incorporate these principles in your life. It's also a great gift for the people around you so that they too can get out of the red zone.
I like that. And then to find out more information about you and things that you're doing, where can they go?
They go to ElizabethLombardo.com.
Perfect. Dr. Lombardo, thanks for joining us.
Thanks. It's always great to be here.